Just as we had drawn the distance time graph and the velocity time graph, we can draw the acceleration time graph. This table gives us the time taken and the corresponding acceleration for a body. Now we plot this information on a graph. We take time on the horizontal axis or the x-axis and acceleration on the vertical axis or y-axis. Now corresponding to each time period, that is 5 seconds, acceleration is 2 meters per second square. So at 5 seconds, we mark a point corresponding to 2 meters per second square. At 10 seconds, acceleration is 2 meters per second square. So at 10 seconds, we mark a point at 2 meters per second square. We do this for all the points. And then we join these points. And this is the acceleration time graph. We see that this is a straight line parallel to the time axis. At time equal to 5 seconds, acceleration is 2 meters per second square. At 15 seconds, acceleration is 2 meters per second square. At 25 seconds, acceleration is 2 meters per second square. So acceleration is constant over time. So we can infer that if the acceleration time graph is a straight line parallel to the time axis, then acceleration is constant over time. That is, it represents a uniform acceleration. What type of motion is represented by this graph? We see that this is the graph. As time increases, acceleration is zero. So at all points in time, acceleration is zero. That means the velocity is not changing. So this graph represents uniform velocity or uniform motion.